In today's video, we will be telling you about the billionaire who led the first all-civilian mission to orbit aboard a SpaceX Crew Dragon spacecraft, Jared Isaacman, who recently bought seats for another three missions to go to space. So, what is he planning to do in these missions? How much will these seats cost him? And how will Elon Musk and SpaceX benefit from this? In 2021, billionaire Jared Isaacman flew to Earth orbit on SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule, and he plans to fly with SpaceX again this year. Isaacman announced that he just purchased three more SpaceX flights on a series of Polaris missions that will take him deeper into space on the company's spacecraft. Isaacman, who built his fortune from his payment processing company Shift4 Payments, made news when he bankrolled a full SpaceX Crew Dragon passenger trip named Inspiration 4 in September 2021. Other citizen astronauts, including a childhood cancer survivor, an engineer, and a professor, were seated in the vehicle's three remaining seats. While raising money for St. Jude Children's Research Hospital, all four civilians were trained and eventually flew to space together on a three-day expedition. Isaacman now appears to be planning to recreate his Inspiration 4 expedition on even greater stages. Two missions aboard SpaceX's Crew Dragon would go to super high orbits above Earth as part of the three flights he's purchased, laying the groundwork for the company's massive new Starship rocket's first crewed voyage. Isaacman intends to fly again on the first Crew Dragon voyage, called Polaris Dawn. Scott Kidd Poteet, a former Air Force pilot who was the mission director for Inspiration 4, is filling the remaining seats with two SpaceX workers, Sarah Gillis and Anna Menon. The flight would also serve as another fundraising opportunity for St. Jude, so SpaceX would also be supporting a noble cause while gaining good publicity for the mission. If the voyage is successful, it will take SpaceX's Crew Dragon spacecraft to the greatest height it has ever flown, let alone with passengers on board. According to Isaacman, the Polaris Dawn trip will travel further into space than humans have gone since we last walked on the moon. The Crew Dragon has only flown from low Earth orbit back and forth so far. SpaceX's Crew Dragon's primary mission is to transport humans and cargo equipment and supplies to and from the International Space Station for NASA. In May of 2020, SpaceX launched its first crew of NASA astronauts aboard the vehicle, which was followed by a number of other crews over the next few years. However, the business has begun to venture out, having flown its first wholly private mission with Inspiration 4, and wants to conduct a series of private missions to the International Space Station for the company Axiom. Crew Dragon flights are intended to be test missions for SpaceX's deep space human travel, while also showing certain new capabilities. Polaris Dawn will feature a commercial spacewalk, which will be the first of its kind. The walker will wear a new sort of spacesuit built for spacewalks that SpaceX is currently designing based on the pressure suits used by crew members on the Crew Dragon. The voyage would also put SpaceX's Starlink laser-based communications in space to the test, allowing the company to tap into the vast satellite constellation it's creating to give global broadband service. Because the voyage will transport the four-person crew into the Van Allen Belt, a zone of radiated particles trapped in Earth's magnetic field that extends deep into space, the mission will also explore how the crew handles a deeper space environment. Following the announcement, the Polaris Dawn team had a press conference where they revealed more details of the mission. They didn't specify the altitude for their journey, but instead, they only said that they aim to fly to the highest Earth orbit ever achieved. Isaacman said, "If you reference the Gemini mission, that'll give you an idea of the target." When asked about the progress of the spacewalk suit, the crew refused to disclose how far the design had advanced. "There is a fantastic team of brilliant engineers working on a spacesuit, and it'll be really exciting to work together as their design unfolds," Anna Menon, a SpaceX worker, said. She further added, "And we'll be certain to share more details with you as we get to that point." While the mission's spacewalker has yet to be chosen, the team has stated that the spacewalker would have to leave through an open doorway, exposing the rest of the group to the vacuum of space. Menon said, "There is no airlock, and so we will certainly be taking the entire team of four down to the vacuum. We'll certainly be doing so safely." Currently, astronauts on Crew Dragon wear an iconic black and white pressure suit during launch and re-entry, which is designed to keep humans alive in the event of a rapid depressurization accident. Although those suits aren't designed to be worn during a spacewalk, they may be able to keep astronauts safe in a vacuum for an extended period of time. Now, before we tell you the estimated costs of these seats, we would like to thank you for making it to this part of the video. You can further extend your support by liking this video and subscribing to our channel. Now, let us move on. Isaacman wouldn't specify how much he's spending on the project in terms of money, only that the Polaris Initiative is a joint venture between him and SpaceX. "We know space is expensive," Isaacman said. "At this point, costs will come down, just as they have from any other groundbreaking technology." Of course, even though the exact number has not yet been revealed, it is safe to assume that these seats would easily cost Isaacman somewhere in seven digits, maybe even more than $5 or $10 million in total. Polaris Dawn is scheduled to launch in the fourth quarter of 2022, with further information on the other missions to come. These flights will eventually culminate in the first crewed launch of SpaceX's Starship vehicle, a massive rocket SpaceX has been constructing for several years to transport large crews to the moon and eventually, as per SpaceX's plan, even to Mars. Isaacman said he might be available for the two follow-up missions. "If we achieve our objectives on Polaris Dawn and don't disappoint, I'll have the opportunity to participate in future Polaris missions," he said. However, Isaacman may have to wait a bit for his last Starship voyage, as the spacecraft is still in development and has yet to fly into space. The company conducted a couple of high-altitude test launches with Starship in 2020 and 2021, sending the aircraft to 3,200 feet before attempting to land it. During those testings, Starship only managed to land without blowing up once. SpaceX hopes to fly Starship into orbit this year, though the company's test flights are dependent on the Federal Aviation Administration giving the company regulatory authority to launch Starship from its South Texas launch facility. The FAA had previously stated that a decision on whether or not to grant that approval would be made by the end of February 2022, but then later announced that the deadline would be extended until the end of March. Even if SpaceX manages to send Starship into orbit in 2022, the company still has a long way to go before carrying passengers into deep space on the vehicle. The company must create life support systems, figure out how to fuel the ship in space, and prove that it can land the astronauts safely back on Earth after the journey into deep space. The chances are that this entire process can take years to develop. Hence, Musk hinted in his New Year's tweet that maybe 2030 could be the year that humans start to land on Mars.